Story: the warm golden hues of a setting sun painted the beach in shades of orange and red as families played in the gentle surf, their laughter carried by the salty breeze. It was supposed to be a peaceful evening, a perfect end to the day for those who had gathered by the sea. But high above, hidden against the dimming sky, the familiar roar of jet engines began to sound strange. British Airways Flight 772, an Airbus A380-800, was in trouble. The massive aircraft en route from London to New York was carrying 560 passengers and 22 crew members. Most on board were either engrossed in in-flight entertainment or resting, unaware of the growing crisis in the cockpit. One of the four powerful engines had caught fire shortly after takeoff, but the situation worsened rapidly as the fire spread to a second engine. The pilots, seasoned professionals with thousands of hours of experience, immediately declared an emergency. They knew their options were limited. The damage was catastrophic, and the aircraft's altitude was dropping faster than they could stabilize it. As smoke billowed from the burning engines, the flight attendant sprang into action, moving swiftly through the aisles, ensuring passengers were seated and their seatbelts securely fastened. The atmosphere in the cabin grew tense. Parents held their children tightly, some whispering prayers, others staring out of the windows in stunned silence as flames and thick black smoke enveloped the wing. The captain's voice came over the intercom, calm but urgent. "Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We are experiencing an engine malfunction. Please remain calm and follow all crew instructions. We will be making an emergency landing shortly." Below, on the crowded beach, the roar of the engines grew louder, drawing the attention of sunbathers and swimmers. Heads turned upward, searching the skies. What they saw was horrifying. The massive A380 descending rapidly, black smoke trailing behind it. Panic rippled through the crowd as the realization set in. The plane was going to crash, and it was heading straight for the coastline. In the cockpit, the pilots fought valiantly to maintain control. The controls were sluggish, the aircraft unresponsive to many of their commands. The fire had caused significant damage to the hydraulics and electrical systems. The captain made a split-second decision. A controlled crash landing on the beach was the only hope of minimizing casualties. He aimed for a stretch of sand away from the densest part of the crowd, shouting commands to his co-pilot as alarms blared around them. The cabin erupted into chaos as the plane descended. Passengers screamed, some clutching their seats, others crying or shouting prayers. Flight attendants braced for impact, their faces pale but determined. The ground came rushing toward them. In those final moments, time seemed to slow. Parents shielded their children. Couples held each other tightly, and many prepared for what they believed would be their last moments. The impact was deafening. The plane slammed into the sand with an earth-shaking force, tearing apart the landing gear and sending chunks of debris flying in every direction. The nose of the aircraft dug into the ground, creating a massive spray of sand and seawater as the fuselage broke apart. One of the still-burning engines exploded on impact, sending fiery debris into the air and intensifying the flames that now engulfed the wreckage. One of the A380's massive engines had caught fire mid-flight. The cabin filled with the acrid smell of burning fuel, and passengers screamed as the plane jolted violently. Smoke began to seep through the air ducts, causing panic to spread like wildfire. Overhead, bins popped open, spilling luggage onto passengers below. Flight attendants rushed to calm everyone, their own fear barely concealed behind forced smiles. "Ladies and gentlemen, please remain calm," one attendant shouted over the chaos. But calm was impossible. The impact was catastrophic. The A380 hit the sand with a bone-shaking crash, sending a massive plume of sand and debris into the air. The fuselage groaned under the strain, splintering in places as the wings scraped against the ground. One of the engines, still ablaze, exploded on impact, scattering fiery debris across the beach. The nose of the aircraft crumpled as it came to a grinding halt just meters from the water's edge. For a moment, there was silence, a stunned, eerie quiet as the beach lay blanketed in smoke. Inside the wreckage, survivors struggled to free themselves. Seats were mangled, luggage was strewn everywhere, and the acrid smell of burning fuel filled the air. A mother clawed at her seatbelt, trying to release her crying toddler from his harness. A businessman with a bloodied face crawled over shattered glass, gasping for air. One flight attendant, her uniform torn and face streaked with soot, shouted directions over the chaos. "Follow the lighted pathways. Leave everything behind and move toward the exits." On the beach, the scene was one of pure chaos. Witnesses screamed and scattered as the massive jet came to rest just meters from the water's edge. Fire erupted from the broken fuselage, black smoke billowing into the sky. Emergency exits were flung open, and terrified passengers began to pour out, some stumbling and falling in their desperate rush to escape the burning wreckage. The screams of the injured and the cries of children filled the air, mingling with the roar of the flames. Local emergency services arrived quickly, their vehicles skidding to a halt on the sand. Firefighters leaped into action, directing powerful streams of water at the flames. Paramedics set up triage areas on the beach, tending to the injured as they were carried out of the wreckage. Some passengers were unconscious, their faces pale and bloodied. Others clung to the rescuers, sobbing in relief or shock. Among the survivors was Sarah, a young mother traveling with her 5-year-old daughter, Emily. When the plane crashed, Sarah had thrown herself over Emily to protect her from the impact. Now, as they were pulled from the wreckage, Sarah was too weak to move. Emily, though unharmed, refused to let go of her mother, clinging to her hand as tears streamed down her face. A paramedic knelt beside them, gently prying Emily's fingers from her mother's hand so she could be treated. "You're both going to be okay," he reassured them, though his voice betrayed his uncertainty. Nearby, an elderly man named Harold was helping a fellow passenger, a young man with a broken leg, hobble away from the wreckage. Harold's face was streaked with blood from a cut on his forehead, but he refused to leave the injured man behind. "We're going to make it," he said firmly, his voice steady despite the chaos around them. The fire, fueled by jet fuel, raged on, defying the efforts of the firefighters. One of the engines continued to burn fiercely, sending plumes of thick black smoke into the sky. The heat was intense, forcing rescuers to retreat as they worked tirelessly to save those still trapped inside. A firefighter, his uniform singed and face drenched in sweat, emerged from the wreckage carrying a young boy in his arms. The child's face was pale, his eyes wide with shock, but he was alive. The beach, once a place of tranquility, had become a scene of unimaginable devastation. The ocean waves lapped at the wreckage, washing away debris and bloodstains as the setting sun cast an eerie glow over the scene. Bystanders stood at a safe distance, many of them filming the disaster on their phones, their faces a mix of horror and disbelief. For some, the sight was too much to bear, and they turned away, their hands covering their mouths as tears streamed down their cheeks. As night fell, the rescue operation continued. Helicopters circled overhead, their searchlights cutting through the smoke and darkness. Survivors were loaded onto stretchers and carried to waiting ambulances. Some clung to their rescuers, whispering words of gratitude. Others sat silently, staring into the distance, their minds unable to process the trauma they had just endured. In the days that followed, the crash of British Airways Flight 772 would dominate headlines around the world. Investigations revealed that a catastrophic engine failure, combined with an electrical malfunction, had caused the tragedy. The bravery of the flight crew and the emergency responders was widely praised, credited with saving hundreds of lives in what could have been an even greater disaster. For those who survived, the scars, both physical and emotional, would remain forever. Sarah and Emily, though alive, would never forget the terror of that day. Harold, hailed as a hero for his selflessness, would later admit that he still heard the screams in his dreams. The passenger